हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग सर, स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू जूलॉजी ऑनलाइन क्लास, सेकेंड सेमेस्टर जूलॉजी क्लास. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ इंटेगुमेंट, इंटेगुमेंट एंड इट्स डेरिवेटिव्स इन वर्टिब्रेट्स. सो डेरिवेटिव्स आर नॉट देयर इन योर सिलेबस. इंटेगुमेंट स्ट्रक्चर एंड इट्स कंपेरेटिव अकाउंट इन डिफरेंट classes of vertebrates, we have to start. So what is integument? Introduction. Integument is nothing but skin. See, the integument or the skin forms the external protective covering of an animal. It is continuous with the mucous membrane lining the mouth, rectum, nostrils, eyelids and opening of urogenital ducts. See, the all vertebrates are externally covered by protective layer called skin, and this skin is continuous with the mucous membrane lining of the mouth, rectum. Mouth has mucous membrane. That mucous membrane is nothing but the continuation of the skin, and it is also present in the rectum, nostrils, eyelids and the opening of the urogenital ducts. Conjunctiva of eyeball. Eyeball is externally covered by conjunctiva. Conjunctiva of eyeball and outer surface of eardrum is also skin. It is also skin. So the skin comes in contact with the environment, terrestrial or aquatic. See, the skin directly comes in contact with the environment, surrounding environment. If the animal is aquatic, the skin comes in contact with water. If it is terrestrial, it comes in contact with the atmosphere, and it influences the character of the skin. The external environment influences the character of the skin. The evolution of the vertebrate integument is correlated with the transition of vertebrates from an aquatic to a terrestrial environment. See, evolution of the skin. Or evolution of the skin, I mean integument, is correlated with the transition of animals from aquatic environment to terrestrial environment. Okay, first the vertebrates were evolved in water. The vertebrates again, it has two groups, Agnatha and Gnathostomata. In Agnatha, the cyclostomes, they are present in water, and in Gnathostomata, fishes, they are aquatic. The remaining amphibians are aquatic as well as terrestrial. Reptilians are terrestrial. Aves are terrestrial. Mammals are terrestrial. See, thus they are moving from aquatic medium to terrestrial medium, therefore their structure of the skin also changes to in order to adjust with the external environment. Structure of skin. The vertebrate skin differs from that of invertebrates in having two layers. The vertebrate skin having two layers. An outer layer is epidermis. It has two layers. Outer layer is epidermis, it is derived from the ectoderm, and the inner layer is the dermis, or it's also called as corium. It is formed from the mesenchyme of dermatomes or mesoderm. So dermis is derived from the mesoderm, epidermis is derived from ectoderm. The relative amount of the two layers varies with the environment. The amount of these two layers, epidermis and dermis, varies with the environment. So let us discuss the functions of integument. Okay, so the first function is the protection. The integument forms a covering of the body and is protective. Okay, it protects the body against entry of foreign bodies and against mechanical injuries. So integument forms a covering of the body and it is protective. It protects the entry of foreign bodies against mechanical and against mechanical injuries. It protects the tissues against excessive loss of moisture. Excessive loss of moisture. This is very important. Because both aquatic and terrestrial animals are dependent upon water in their bodies for various metabolic activities. So this skin protects the internal tissues from evaporation of water. So moisture is necessary for the body, and that is loss is prevented by the presence of integument. The integument forms protective derivatives such as scales, bony plates, layer of fat, feathers and hair, which reduce the effect of injurious contacts. In some animals, the skin shows protective coloration, which makes the animals resemble their environment. You know, chameleon is an example which performs mimicry. It is an example for camouflage. It changes its body color according to its background. So thus, skin helps the animal in protecting the animal from its enemies, thus making them almost invisible to their enemies. Okay, so they become invisible for their enemies. This is the main function of the skin. Next function is the temperature control. Skin also controls temperature. Heat is produced constantly by oxidation of food in tissues. This heat is distributed evenly by the circulating blood. The heat is circulated to all the body parts. The body heat is lost constantly with expired breath, with feces and urine also, and from the surface of the skin heat is lost. Okay, the integument regulates heat and maintains a constant temperature in endothermal animals. Means warm-blooded animals. So in warm-blooded animals, the integument regulates heat and maintains a constant temperature in endothermal animals. In warm-blooded animals like birds and mammals, the body temperature remains same all the time. So that is controlled by skin. In birds, the heat is regulated by adjustment of feathers. Okay, so in mammals, constant evaporation of sweat regulates the body heat. In cold weather, contraction of skin's blood capillaries reduces the loss of body heat. In some animals, fat in the skin prevents loss of heat because it is non-conductor of heat. So fat is a non-conductor of heat. Okay. Next, food storage. Third function of the skin is food storage. The skin stores fat. It stores fat in its layers as reserve food. As reserve food material, which is used for nourishment in times of need. In whales and seals, the fat of the skin forms a thick layer. That thick layer is known as blubber. Okay, so called blubber, which is not only reserve food but also maintains the body temperature. The reserve food is blubber. Blubber is nothing but fat layer. Fat layer present in aquatic mammals. So it not only stores the food, it also maintains the body temperature. So next function of the skin is secretion. The skin acts as an organ of secretion. Glands of the skin are secretory. In aquatic forms, there are secretory mucous glands whose secretion keep the skin moist and slippery. So usually the aquatic animals are slippery because their skin has mucus secreting glands. Therefore, they are slippery. If you touch the fish body is slippery. Frog body is also slippery. It is because of the presence of mucus secreting glands in the skin. In mammals, sebaceous glands secrete oil. In mammals, skin, sebaceous glands are. In our body, sebaceous glands secrete oil, which lubricates the skin and hairs. It lubricates skin and hairs. Mammary glands. Mammary glands produce milk for nourishment of the young one. In birds, no sweat glands are there. No sweat glands, no oil glands except the europoisal gland. Europoisal glands secrete oil for preening the feathers. Feathers are smeared with oil, which is secreted by the europoisal glands. Odors of scent glands attract the opposite sex. Lacrimal glands are present in eyes. Secretion wash the conjunctiva of the eyeball in mammals. Earwax, cerumen secreted by the glands of auditory meatus, greases the eardrums and avoids insects to enter the canal. So your external ear has cerumen glands which secrete oily secretion, which avoids the entry of insects into the canal. Next function of the skin is excretion. The integument acts as an organ of excretion. Shedding of the corneal layer during ecdysis removes some waste substances. You know, ecdysis means molting, shedding of external skin in insects, reptilians. It removes some waste substances. In mammals, metabolic waste such as salts, urea and water is also released out from the sweat glands. It is removed from the blood by means of sweat. Chloride secreting cells are also found in gills of marine fishes. Marine fishes gills possess the chloride secreting cells. So the skin is also acting as secretory organ. Then sensation. The skin is an important sense organ because it has various kinds of tactile cells and corpuscles which are sensory to touch, temperature changes, heat, cold, pressure and pain. So all these functions, all these stimuli are perceived by skin. Skin is sensitive to touch, it is sensitive to temperature changes such as heat and cold. It is also sensitive to pressure changes and it is also sensitive to pain. So all these receptors are present in the skin. Therefore, skin is also a sensory organ. Then respiration. Part of skin in respiration. In amphibians, the moist skin acts as an organ of respiration. In amphibians, you know it. Frogs, when they are in water, their skin is used as a respiratory organ. Through the skin, exchange of gases occur. In frogs, the respiratory function of the skin is greater than that of the lungs. So lungs are used when the frog is outside the water. when it is present inside the water, skin is used for respiration. So this is another important function of the skin. Then locomotion. So derivatives of the integument bring about locomotion in some animals, such as the fins of fishes aid in locomotion in water. You know, fishes have fins. With the help of fins, they show their movement in water. So the web of skin in the feet of frogs. Frogs, in between digits of their legs, they have web, extension of the skin, that is called web. This web is used for swimming. And aquatic birds aid in swimming. So this web is also present in aquatic birds also. Feathers of the wings and tail of birds are used for flying. Feathers of wings in birds, tail of birds are used for flying. Feathers are present in wings as well as in tail. Both are used for flying. And extensions of the integument forming wings of flying lizards. Extinct pterodactyls, flying squirrels and bats. All these have skin derivatives. They are used for locomotion. Then dermal endoskeleton. The skin contributes to the endoskeleton. It forms the dermal bones of vertebrates and also forms parts of the teeth. Endoskeleton of head protects the brain, means the cranium, skull. Part of the skull is cranium. This cranium protects the brain and sense organs. In the body, it protects the soft, tender viscera. The endoskeleton protects the soft, tender viscera, soft bodies, soft organs. Then the sexual selection. Skin also takes part in sexual selection. The skin acts as an organ of sexual selection. It provides the feathers of birds, which often have brilliant colors, which are for sexual attraction. Some integumentary glands of mammals produce odors for attracting the opposite sex. Antlers of male deer distinguishes it from female. Male and female deer are different. Male deer has antlers. Antlers means horns, type of horns they are. They are present in male deer only, not in female deer. So in peacock, the plumage is attractive in males, not in females. Okay. So besides the above functions, mammalian skin synthesizes the vitamin D with the help of sebum of sebaceous glands. Brood pouches beneath the skin in some fishes and amphibians protect unhatched eggs. Nasal glands of tetrapods keep the nostrils free of dirt and water. Skin also have the power of absorption of oils, ointments, etc. So these are the functions of integument, different functions of integument. So today we discussed the introduction of skin or integument and the functions, some functions of integument we discussed. So in the next class, we shall discuss the comparative account of skin structure in fishes, amphibians, reptiles, aves and mammals. So now at the end of this class, I would like to give you one assignment. Okay, so today's assignment for you people is, write any two functions of integument. Write any two functions of integument. So write its answer and send it to me through Google Classroom app. Thank you.